and inhale, tilt your head back, lift the chin to the sky, and exhale, chin to the chest, drop the head forward. Inhale, head back, exhale, chin to the chest. Inhale, head back, stretch the front of the neck, exhale, head forward. Inhale, roll your head to the left and back, and exhale, roll it to the right and down. Inhale, to the right and back, exhale, to the left and down. Again, inhale, left and back, exhale, right and down. Inhale, to the right and back, exhale, left and down. Inhale, bring your head to neutral. Exhale, all the breath out. Inhale with your arms, stretch them up, reach tall. Exhale, bowing forward, release your head, neck, and shoulders, dropping yourself all the way in and down as you breathe into the back. Release deeper with your exhales, taking this moment to surrender. Inhale, walk your fingertips forward a little bit further. And exhale as you walk your hands in. Come all the way back up to seated, switch legs. Again, take a moment. Ujjayi breathing, feel the filter, the activation in the back of the throat with the breath. Make sure the exhales are complete. Inhale as you stretch your arms back up again, and exhale, come forward. Release down like the head and neck, and shoulders release down, breathing into the back. Sink in with your exhalations. Releasing, letting go, clearing the mind. Inhale as you walk your fingertips forward a little bit further. Exhale, walking your hands back in, and slowly let's come forward to hands and knees and take it into our spinal warm-up. On an inhale, tilt your tailbone, drop your belly, lift your chin for cow pose, and with your exhale, tuck your chin, push through the upper back, hug your navel in. Inhale into your cow pose, pulling the shoulders back. Exhale, pressing up and in for your cat pose. Inhale, lift the chin, feel the stretch through the front of the neck. And exhale, tuck the chin, feel the stretch through the back of the neck. Again, inhale. And exhale, lift your knees up, lift your hips up, ground those heels down, and breathe into the back. Let's bend the knees. And then inhale, look up. Exhale, bend the knees, push your hips back. Inhale, look up and forward. Exhale, bend the knees, pressing your belly towards your thighs. And inhale, looking forward, lifting the chin. Exhale as you drop your right heel to the floor, bend your left knee. Inhale, look forward again. Exhale, press your left heel to the floor, bend your right knee. Inhale, look forward. And exhale to the right, right heel down. Inhale, look forward. Exhale to the left, left heel down. Inhale, looking forward. And exhale, press both heels down. Push back deeper. Inhale, exhale, bend the knees, gaze up. Walk or hop your feet lightly to the hands. Inhale to halfway, flat back. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, rolling up to standing, reaching with the arms. Exhale, palms together, hands to the heart. Inhale as you stretch your arms back up. Exhale, dive it forward and stretch it down. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold in. Inhale to standing again. Root through your feet, sweep the arms up, arch it back. Exhale, palms together, back to the heart. Inhale, one more time with this half sun salutation. Exhale, folding forward, tucking your chin. Inhale, lengthening through the back of your neck. Exhale, folding in. Inhale, rise to standing again, rooting through the feet. Exhale, palms together, heart center. find your breath. Inhale, stretch your arms back up. Exhale, diving forward again. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, plant the hands. Walk or hop your feet back, and let's come into our plank position. Really push up through your upper back. Inhale, exhale, lower to your chaturanga, and inhale to your cobra or upward dog. Exhale, take it back into your downward dog pose and breathe as you release any tension in the neck and the jaw and the back of the head. Inhale, push back. Exhale, bend the knees, gaze up, walk or hop your feet lightly. Inhale, halfway, and exhale, fold in. Inhale, rising to standing again, root down as you reach high. Exhale, palms together, heart center. One breath for every movement. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale to halfway, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, plant the hands, walk or hop it, your vinyasa. Lowering on an exhale, lifting the heart on an inhale, and exhale, taking it back into your downward dog pose. Now remember, you can always modify that vinyasa using your knees or skipping it entirely. Whatever you need to do to make this practice work for you. Inhale to your right leg, reach your right leg up. Exhale, swing your right foot through, keep your back heel lifted. Inhale as you rise to crescent pose, high lunge on your right side. Nice and strong and open and balanced in our crescent pose. We're gonna inhale and interlace the fingers, bring them to the back of the head or the back of the neck, and lean the head back as you open the elbows and the shoulders wide. Inhale, straighten your front knee, press your head into your hands, and then exhale, bend both knees, tuck your chin into the chest. Inhale, straighten both knees, lift your heart up. Exhale, bend both knees, let the elbows come forward. Inhale, open the heart up. Exhale, tucking the chin in. Inhale, press the head into the hands. Exhale, contract, elbows in. One more here. Inhale, open it up. Exhale, contract. Hold it here. Breathe into the back of the neck. Hug your navel in. Let your elbows come forward. Breathe. On an inhale, reach your arms out wide. Lift up off of your back foot. Let's come into warrior three with airplane arms, arms out to the side. Expand out through your fingertips, flex through your back foot, drop your left hip, reach the crown of the head forward. Breathe. Take an inhale. Exhale, bend your right knee, step your left toes back. Inhale as you circle the arms back up. Exhale, lower the hands. Swing your right foot back and flow through your vinyasa. You can, of course, use your knees. Take a cobra instead of up dog if you'd like. However, you need to modify that vinyasa as we move through. Breathe deep. Next, inhale. Left leg reaches. Reach your left leg up. Exhale, swing your left foot through. Keep your back heel lifted. Inhale, crescent. High lunge on your left side. Bend into that front knee. Square off your hips and shoulders. Exhale as you bend in deeper. Inhale, interlace the fingers. Place the head into the hands and press back into those hands, activating the muscles in the back of the neck. Inhale. With your exhale, slowly bring the elbows in, tuck your chin in. Inhale, press your front knee straight, lift your heart up, lift your chin up. Exhale, tuck your chin in, let your elbows come forward. Inhale, open the heart up. Exhale, contract everything in and down. Inhale, press the head into the hands. Exhale, hug the navel in and breathe into the back of your neck, holding this. Breathing, stretching. Inhale as you come forward. Expand your arms out. Flex your back foot. Reach the crown of the head forward. Hug your navel and drop your right hip. Balancing. Try to feel lightness and freedom. flying here. Take an inhale. Exhale, bend your left knee, step your right toes back. Inhale to your crescent, reach those arms. Exhale as you lower. Swing your left foot back and again flow through your vinyasa however you would like to do it. And breathe. Deep inhales, long exhalations. Tuck your chin in for Jalandhara Bandha. Activating the throat center. Let's inhale, push back. Exhale, bend the knees, gaze up, walk or hop. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, squat deep, reach high, Utkatasana. Let's come into our first chair pose. Drop your hips back, put the weight into your heels, lift your toes up. As you exhale, see if you can sink in a little deeper. With your inhale, feel your arms extend. Slowly lift up onto your toes. You begin balance on your toes, lifting the heels off the floor, hugging everything into the center. Your knees squeezing together, your navel pulling in. Take an inhale, exhale, drop into your hips, into your heels. Inhale, straighten your legs, reach up. Exhale, bow forward and dive down. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, walk or hop. Your vinyasa. Light and smooth and airy is how we want to feel as we move through this Gemini practice. Inhale, right leg, reach your right leg. Exhale, swing your right foot through, keep your back heel lifted again, inhale to crescent, bending into that front knee. With your right hand, wrap it around your left wrist and gently pull your left arm, your left hand, your left wrist over to the right side. And then turn your head to look down underneath your right hip towards the floor. Breathe into that left side, feeling a stretch through the side body, through the side of the shoulder, even maybe even through the back of the neck. Inhale, let's come forward back to Virabhadrasana 3, this time arms extending straight out alongside the ears. Lengthen through your heel, inhale. And then exhale, right fingertips to the floor, left arm to the sky. Extend through those top fingertips, looking up at the thumb, hugging your navel in, pressing out through your back heel. Breathe, balance. Inhale, reach the left arm over. Exhale, lower the left hand, and then come back to your warrior three with the T. Step your left toes back, big inhale and crescent. Exhale, lower down, right foot back. Your vinyasa, slowly, fluidly, breathing deeply. Inhale, left leg, reach your left leg up. Exhale, swing your left foot through, keep your back heel lifted. Inhale to crescent, reach your heart up. Exhale, drop into your front knee a little bit deeper with your left hand, wrap it around your right wrist and gently pull over to the left, breathing into the right side body and looking down underneath the left hip as we feel the stretch through the right side, the right shoulder. Breathe into it. Inhale, circle the arms back and then forward as you come forward off of your back foot to warrior three, Virabhadrasana 3 on the left side. Extend your arms, reach through your fingertips, lengthen through the sides of your waist. Slowly lowering left fingertips to the floor, right hand to the sky. Let's take Ardha Chandrasana on the left side. Play with where you would like to set your gaze. It can be up, sideways, or down. Deep breathing no matter what. Light on those left fingertips. Inhale, let's bring the top arm over the head. Exhale, lower and lift back up again in arms in a T. Inhale. Exhale, step your left right toes back. Inhale to crescent. Exhale, lower down slow. Flow through your vinyasa. Remember, modify or skip that vinyasa whenever you need to. Breathe deep. Inhale, push back. Exhale, bend the knees, gaze up. Walk or hop your feet lightly. Inhale to halfway. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, squat deep, reach high. Utkatasana. Let's come into our second chair pose. Drop back into the hips. We're going to interlace the fingers behind the back of the neck again and press the head into the back of the hand, into the palms of the hands, activating the muscles in the back of the neck. Keep your shoulders away from the ears, and with an exhale, let the elbows come in, let the chin tuck in, and breathe into the back of the neck. Hug your navel in, keep your knees bent. Inhale, exhale, pulling a little bit closer, chin to the chest. A few more breaths. Inhale, lifting back up. Exhale, dropping into your chair pose. Inhale, straighten up and reach. Exhale, bow forward and dive down. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, walk or hop. Vinyasa. Slow, strong, smooth. Let's come back onto our bellies. Bring your fingertips on the floor and tighten your fingertips just outside of your shoulders. We're going to inhale, lift the chest up, glue the legs to the floor, and exhale, lower the head to the floor. Inhale, lift the chest up. Exhale, lowering the chest, keeping your elbows lifted. Inhale, look over your right shoulder. Exhale, look over the left shoulder. Inhale, right shoulder. Exhale, left shoulder. You can come a little lower or stay lifted higher, twisting the shoulders just a little bit, working through the sides of the neck, pulling the shoulders away from the ears. Breathe as you continue to alternate right and left. And then finally, lower all the way down. Rest your head on the floor in your hands and breathe into your back. Long exhalations. Let's bring the hands underneath the shoulders. Inhale into a baby cobra. Exhale, press into the hands. Lift the knees. Take it back into a downward dog pose. Inhale, push back. Exhale, bend the knees, gaze up, walk or hop. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold in. Hold in her forward fold. Yogi clasp the big toes. Take an inhale, lift halfway, and then exhale. Pull yourself in towards your legs, tucking your chin in, bending your knees as much as you need to, and using your elbows and your arms to pull you in closer. Tuck your chin all the way in. Tuck your navel all the way in. All bandhas engaged. Let's inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, bring your right hand to your hip. Continue to clasp your left big toe. And slowly, using your core, see if you can rise up into Uttita Padangushtasana, so standing balance. You can open that hip and the leg out to the left and look over your right shoulder. Breathe. Balance. Root into your bottom foot. And then slowly bringing the leg back to center. Slowly lowering the leg down underneath the left hip. Inhale halfway. Exhale, fold in. Other side. Let's bring the left hand to the hip. Put all your weight into your left foot as we slowly and simultaneously lift that foot up and lift the torso up. And extend that heel out and then open the hip out and turn your head over your left shoulder away from the foot as you breathe in balance. So remember, you can keep the knee bent and the hand on the inside of the knee or underneath the knee, or you can yogi clasp. Inhale, take it back to center. Exhale, use your core muscles to gently lower it down to the floor. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold yourself back in. Breathe a few breaths here in this forward fold. Inhale, exhale, walk or hop your feet back. Flow through one last vinyasa. Lifting those hips up, grounding those heels down, pressing the chest open, lengthening through the back of the neck. Let's inhale, push back. Exhale, bend the knees, gaze up, walk or hop. We're going to come up onto the toes, press into the fingertips, and practice an arm balance. So you can practice bakasana or crane pose or crow pose. Let's just bring the toes together if your feet are off the floor, or just practice putting the weight into your fingertips. Gently lower down, come to seated, and let's bring the hands to the heart and lower to lower boat, straight into our yoga walks. Press your low back into the floor. Press your belly in towards the spine. Lift your head, neck, and shoulder blades off the floor, walking it out one step at a time. Breathe. And gently hug the knees in. Inhale, exhale. Rock the hips side to side. Let your head roll side to side. Bringing the feet flat onto the floor. Hips distance. Hips width distance. Turn your toes slightly in. Exhale the breath out and then inhale. Just come into Setubandha, a low bridge pose. You can turn the palms up. You can have robot arms, or you can interlace your fingers as you press your pinky fingers and forearms into the floor. And then see if you can come up onto your toes, lifting the heels up, lifting those hips up, engaging the glutes. And then extend your left leg up to the ceiling. Point the foot, splay the toes. Keeping that right heel lifted, pressing down through the shoulders. Lower the leg. Let's bring the right knee in and extend your right foot up. Press into the ball of the left foot. Tuck your chin in, press the back of the neck into the floor, and slowly release. Inhale so you can squeeze up a little bit higher. Keeping those heels lifted, drawing your tailbone under, hugging your navel in, pressing through the sides of the shoulders, and slowly with an exhale, lowering all the way down, vertebrae by vertebrae, tucking your knees into your chest. And counter back bend with some hip circles. Roll it front to back, right along the spine. And let's slowly come to seated for Paschimottanasana. Inhale as you reach your arms up. Exhale, hinge forward at the hips. You can yogi clasp the big toes. You can lengthen with an inhale and then pull in with your exhale. You can do that a few times, or just grab onto your legs or your ankles or your feet and pull yourself right away, all the way in, lengthening and using your exhalation to pull you in closer, release you in deeper, feeling the stretch, tucking the chin in. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, lay down flat onto your back and bring your feet all the way up and over for our plow pose. So Sarvangasana is one of the ideal postures to activate our fifth chakra, our throat center. Bring your hands to the back of the waist, your elbows right behind you, and let's extend the legs up one leg at a time into Sarvangasana, into our shoulder stand. Point your feet, splay the toes, squeeze your legs together, draw your tailbone towards your heels. Breathe deeply, or as deep as you can in this position. Let's bring the legs wide. Bend the knees, bring the soles of your feet together. Temple pose, as always, remembering the temples of our bodies. Bring the knees right over the eyes or right next to the ears, and take a moment to draw all of your senses inward. Gently bring your hands to the mat. Roll yourself out slow, vertebrae by vertebrae. Wedge up onto your elbows. Tilt your head back for fish pose. Opening up the heart, opening up the throat center, tilting the head back. Breathe into the front of your body. Inhale as you lift your head back up. Exhale, lay down flat onto your back, hug your right knee into your chest. Let's bring the right knee over to the left side, supine twist, Reach the right arm out, turn the palm up, let your shoulders release down. Turn your head to the right and breathe into your back. Long exhalation. Slowly bringing the knee back to center. Switch knees, hug your left knee in, extend your right leg long. Slowly bring that knee over to the right and extend your left arm out, turn the palm up. Breathe into the back, let your shoulders release, let your belly release. Turning your head to the left, feel the stretch through the neck. Rolling it back to center, hug both knees into the chest, give yourself a giant squeeze, circle your hips right and left. And gently when you're ready, extending your legs all the way out, turning the palms up with the feet and ankles relax and fall open for our shavasana. Just a few moments to allow the entire practice to become integrated into every level and layer of our being. If you have specific jaw and neck issues or issues with communication or self-expression, you can focus in on the energy center at the center of the throat, visualizing a blue color, a swirling vortex of blue energy right at your throat center.
You're in love, your heart a flutter. All day long, you won't disturb her, cause your poor tongue just will not utter the words. I love you. Ooh, what a little moonlight can do. Wait a while till a little moonbeam comes peeping through. You'll get bored. Can't resist him. All you can do once you have kissed him is
And slowly come back, wiggling the fingers and the toes. Inhale as you stretch your arms up to the head. You can't gently resist. Roll to your right side into a fetal position. Checking back in, just noticing how you feel. Slowly, when you're ready, pressing yourself up to zero. Hand to the heart. Bow the chin to the chest with gratitude. Thank you so much for practicing this Gemini season yoga practice with me.